Join me here as we move and transition from a basic health bounce into a power walk. I want to make sure that you have your feet about hip width distance apart. You've got a slight bend in your knees, a bit of a hinge in your hips, and most importantly, you are firmly engaging your core muscles. You can think of this as drawing your navel back towards your spine. Other kind of silly things I've heard is zipping up a pair of tight jeans, but make sure you're really firming up those abdominal muscles. So here we are, feet hip width distance apart. We're gonna begin with a health bounce. The balls of your feet stay on the trampoline. You're lifting your heels. You don't have to lift them very much, just lightly. If you have the balance and stability support bar attached to your trampoline, certainly be hanging on here. But we're just lifting our heels, taking a few deep breaths, and really, really focusing on our body posture. Keeping that slight bend in the knee, slight hinge in the hips, and nice firm core. Now you may stay here in your health bounce and not be ready to transition for a while, and that's perfectly fine. Hop on your Jump Sport Rebounder, health bounce for a few minutes each day until you feel ready to progress. We're here for just a few more seconds. Deep breath. Very good. Now, I've got my arms pretty low-key here, kind of neutral. You can get a little swing going if you're not holding on to the balance bar. And you'll probably start to feel this in your calves, in your legs. Make sure that you are not pronating or supinating. You're not turning the feet in or out. We've got nice equal weight distribution, and we want to carry that through every single move that we do here today. I want to take a moment to acknowledge the beautiful scenery behind me. I am actually on vacation on a camping trip in Arkansas right now, and it is just a gorgeous, gorgeous location with flowing water and waterfalls, and I just thought it was the perfect place to film this video. All right, moving on. We're going to alternate bending each knee. So it's kind of a walk. We're just bending, picking up your heel, swinging your arms as if you were walking down the street. Deep breaths. Now come back to your form. Are you still engaging your core? We're not locking out our knees at all as we move. This is our walk. We've got two moves complete of five that we're doing here today. Deep breaths. Now, one reason I don't play music in my videos is I figure people have their own taste in music, and if you like to have music on, certainly play whatever it is that you find joyful, whether it's classical or hard rock, whatever that is. Music can be very, very motivating, but I want you to be able to choose your own. All right, moving on. We're gonna make this a double. So we dip, dip, two, 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 two. Double, double, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. Once you get the rhythm and cadence here, I want you to come back to your form. I know, I'm a broken record. Make sure you are still equal weight distribution in the feet. Your knees are tracking over your middle toes. You've got your core engaged. You can see I am really hinging here in the waist. I'm not upright. I'm not upright. I am hinging. Okay? We call that the athletic ready position. I like to think of a volleyball player kind of getting ready on the court, ready to spring into action. All right. Now, moving along, again, we're working from the health bounce to the power walk. This next movement I'm gonna call baby steps to power walk. So with your feet in the middle of the trampoline, hip width distance apart, equal weight distribution, we are gonna take baby steps to get your right foot forward, baby steps back to center, baby steps to get your left foot forward and back, kind of over and over at your own pace, baby steps. Now, I really want you to think about control in your legs here, really controlling that movement. We've still got equal weight distribution in our feet. I know it may be harder to maintain, but this is where it gets really important to keep the proper form. Baby steps. Now, if you're feeling confident and comfortable, certainly you can pick up the pace a little bit. Baby steps. If you have never watched an Earth and Owl video before, and this is your first one, again, let me reintroduce myself. I am Nikki, owner of Earth and Owl. I live in Nebraska. I had a studio, in-person studio, prior to the pandemic, but that changed things. And now my audience is here online, and I couldn't be happier about it. You can find me on YouTube, all the social media platforms, Facebook, Instagram, TikTok even. I have free videos. I have a streaming service available. You can get all the information at earthandowl.com. I am jumping on a JumpSport 350 Pro trampoline. It is one I recommend for just about anyone. All right, are you ready for our final move? We are going to do the full power walk. I think of it a little bit like a cross-country skiing motion. We are switching our feet out. We're eliminating the baby steps and switching. So sometimes I call these switches, but please take your time. You can do one and pause, another and pause. Take your time. Focus on your form. Core engaged. Slight bend in the knees. Slight hinge in the hips. Knees tracking over middle toes. When you're ready, feel free to pick that pace up to the level that works the best for you. And as your mind and body start to connect with the movements you're making, continue to think about how you're holding your body, your posture. Don't forget to take some breaths. If this is your first time rebounding, you may be pretty tired here. I would recommend sticking with this video for weeks even, possibly weeks, before you move on to the next. Master these moves, get comfortable, get confident, then move on to the next video in the series. 20 more seconds right here and we are finished with our first rebounding workout. I can't thank you enough for joining me here today. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Come back to your health bounce for a moment. Keep it nice and low. Take some deep breaths. If you're holding on to the bar, one hand at a time here, big inhale, sweep up. Other side. One more time. Let's do a little step tap, I call this. So step to the side, tap your foot, step to the side, tap your foot. We don't want to just completely stop movement at the end of our rebounding workout. We want to take a minute to let the body cool down, slow down, heart rate come down. But even here in this movement, think about your form. A few more seconds here. All right, take your feet about hip width distance apart. One more deep breath in together through your nose, sigh it out through your mouth. Here we go. Thank you so much for joining me today. See you next time.